Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. Today we're going to be doing something that I think you're going to love. It's the old Santa footprint thing. I don't know if you all remember years ago where you used to take a boot and dip it in baby powder and stamp it like on the ground all the way up to the Christmas tree from the fireplace or from the door. Well, got something a little different today. We're going to be doing this footprint. We're going to be cutting it out of wood, and I'm going to show you how to design these footprints from scratch in LightBurn without having to buy them, pay anybody any money. All you need is a 8x10 or a 12x12 piece of wood, and you can get started doing this on your own. And I'm sorry about the noise in the background, but I am running off a bunch of these today. This is letters from Santa, four layers. The kid puts his letter in there. You hang it up on the fireplace. Not going to be, I've redesigned this file four or five times already. Not going to be odd looking like that one. These new files are coming out beautiful. That's another video coming up probably in about a week or so. And there is a collaboration with some other makers. You're going to enjoy it. But that's another video. This video is going to be these footprints, and basically what you do with this is you take and set these footprints up from your fireplace over to your Christmas tree. Let's jump over into LightBurn and let me show you how to make this from scratch where you don't have to buy any files off of Etsy or anywhere else. Let's jump into LightBurn and get started. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start off by going to Google and finding a footprint. So here we are in Google and I've typed footprint. The next thing I want to do is click on images over here. Then I want to come to tools and I want to come over here to usage rights. And we're going to go down here to Creative Commons. Now in the Creative Commons, we're going to scroll down and look for a boot, and here it is right here. This is public domain vector. We're going to click on that and we're going to copy it. Copy image. Now we can get rid of Google, and back here in LightBurn we will just right click and click paste, and there is the beginnings of our project, our footprint. So now with the graphics selected, we're going to right click on it. I'm going to come down here to trace image. Should be a perfect trace. LightBurn is pretty good about tracing these solid vectors like this. So I'll say OK, and there it is. That is perfect. We'll put that on the red layer. I like to put it on the red layer. Red reminds me of cutting. You can put it on any layer that you want. So now what do we have here? We have the footprint. Let's go ahead and select it, come up to the top, ungroup it. And at this point, we want to get rid of everything that's in the middle. So if I drag from the left to the right, it will select everything that's inside of this box. And I can delete it. If I drag from the right to the left, it selects everything. You see? So we don't want to do that. We want to drag from the left to the right and only encompass the pieces that we don't want, which are these six right here. And we'll go ahead and delete those. Now I've got a font installed on my computer called Merry Christmas, and I've already got it selected. I will include a link to this font so that you can download it with the project and use it as well. Or you can use any font that you want. So I'm going to come over here and click in here. Oh, that height is really small. Let's go six. And we're going to type Santa. So now we've got our font, and this is what we're going to cut out. So now if we select that font, we do have a small problem here because these holes in the A are not going to come out properly. So let's go ahead and fix that before we go any further. The first thing that we need to do is we need to come up here and click on Edit, and we need to convert this to a path so that we can edit the text. So we're going to convert it to a path. Going to come over here on the left side. We're going to click on the Edit Nodes button like that. Come back to the selector tool again. Zoom in a little bit. Click off of it. Drag over that anomaly in the middle that we can't use. Drag over this one. Come back to the primitive tool. We're going to draw a circle, or an oval, actually. So let's just draw an oval, something like that. Select it. Bring this in here. Give it a bit of a turn, because, you know, we want it to look like it belongs to the font. And there we go. So now we have that one. We're going to press the control button and the letter D to duplicate that. And now it's a new copy right on top of the old one. If I use my right arrow key, I can right arrow this over to the other A so that it looks almost perfect. And now we have the proper cutout for Santa. At this point, we can just drag over it all, group it together. Now, what we'll want to do is we need to have two copies of this, but we're not going to copy this yet because we have to position it first and actually come over here and group this together. So let's go ahead and group that together. And now we can take our Santa and size it. So I'll bring it right about here to the middle. Hold down Control and size it proportionately from all sizes. I'm going to roll my mouse wheel to zoom in now and just get it to right where I think it should be. Hold Control again, make it a little bit bigger, and maybe give it a little bit of a tilt like that. And there we go. I think that looks pretty good, just like that. So now I'm going to press Control and the letter D to duplicate it again. I'm going to move it off to the side. We now have one base footprint ready here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this Santa, move it off to the side for a second. I'm going to grab this footprint. I'm going to press Control and the letter D, and you'll see that the little Vegas lights will go out when I do that. So Control, letter D, that means that I have the duplicate there. I'm going to come up here to the top where it says mirror, and we're going to mirror that. And then I'm just going to move it off with my arrow key, and I now have the left and the right foot. And I'll move it down a little bit too, so it looks sort of like a footprint, something like that. And there we go. Now we can place our two Santas, put them right in the right spot. Then we'll grab this Santa, bring it over, and we'll have to arrange this one for the left shoe, like so. And there we go. We now have the left and the right shoe. So let's go ahead and group those. Group that one. Now I'm dragging from the right to the left. All I have to do is touch anything and it'll select everything. So there we go. We have our two grouped footprints and we're ready to finish the design. So I happen to have over here under snow, I happen to have a bunch of snowflakes that I've made already. And I'll include this art library, and I have a couple of North Stars here. I'll include this library with the download so you can do this as well. What I want to do is look for the simplest of designs here because we're doing all cutouts. And this is a good one right here. So I'll bring this snowflake in, bring it up to the top here, hold Control, scale it to size. Now I'll press Control and the letter D to duplicate it. And I'll put this one over here so that we have two of the same. And I'm going to look for another pretty simple one. Double click it to bring it out. I'm going to hold Control, shrink it down. Let's zoom in a little bit. Bring it up here and give it a little bit of a turn. Now I'll press Control and duplicate. And I'm going to mirror it like that. And I'll move it off to the left. Now we see we have to size it a little bit. And these can be all different sizes. So don't worry about that. So I will resize these to fit over here. Now with that one selected, I'll hold Shift. And I'll select this one. And Control and the letter D again to duplicate it. And bring these over here for this shoe. So now we've got the second part of the shoe done. I think the next thing I want to do is the North Star. So I'll double click the North Star over here. I'll shrink this down and we will take and put the North Star into Santa's heel. Give it a bit of a turn, bring it up like that. We'll control and duplicate it. And then again, up top here, we'll mirror it. And we'll just grab that mirrored one, bring it over to here for the other shoe. And we're almost done. So the next thing that we're gonna do is grab another snowflake that's different from the others, but sort of simple. This one looks good. We'll grab this one, shrink it down a little bit, bring it up here. That looks good, just like that. Turn it a little bit. We'll control letter D to duplicate it. Come up here to the mirror, mirror it, drag it over to this one. And now we've got all of our snowflakes. What we do have to do now is we need to drag over all of these and put them on the same red cut layer. So we're just going to drag over everything, put it on the red cut layer. Now we have to look for any anomalies that are in here. And as you can see, there are some. We're going to select this, ungroup it up here. Now click off of it, and we can drag over almost all of it, but not all of it, and hit the delete key. We're going to do the same thing to this one over here. Ungroup, drag over most of it, hit the delete key to get rid of those little anomalies. Doesn't make sense to cut all of these pieces out because they're going to drop out anyway. We'll ungroup this one, drag over most of it, hit the delete key, and now all of this looks like good cutouts, and we're just going to do the same thing over here. Ungroup, drag, delete, ungroup. All right, I'm still in that cold and flu thing going on, so my mind isn't working right. Ungroup, drag, delete, and there we go. And now we have our footprints. Now I can drag over them, group them, group everything together. So now we've got everything ready to go. And the only thing that we need to do, now I do already have Santa's shoes down here. And let me show that to you. So here is my 12-inch version on a piece of 12-inch wood that's already framed and ready to go. Very similar to what we just created over here. Now you notice here, I've framed it with a tool path down here. And this is exactly a 12-inch piece of wood. So we know both of them will cut out. You could lay this on the ground, shake your powder over the top of it, and it'll be perfect two footprints. Now, if you don't have 12-inch pieces of wood, I also have both of them together where you can separate them, or actually, better than that, I have 8x10 piece of wood framed for the left shoe, and then I also have 8x10 for the right shoe in my art library. You can use an 8x10 piece of wood and do the same thing here. So this library is the one that I'm going to share with you that's got everything all ready to go. This is the one that we just made. Let's continue and finish it. So let's take our square tool over here, a rectangle tool, and let's draw a perfect square by holding the shift button and dragging. Select it, put it onto a tool path. Now, what size wood are you going to use is the question. So let's say it's 12 by 12. We will do 12 and press enter. And we now have a 12 by 12 piece of wood. I will center that on the page like so. And what I'll do is I'll grab both of these without wasting too much wood. Put it right down there like so. And now this project, all we have to do is come up here, set our speed, our power, and we're ready to cut. All right, so there you go. Full tutorial, start to finish. Anybody can do this. And let me show you, let me bring up a picture of the final product. This is the final product right here. And what you're gonna do with this is, now there are lots of different ways to do this. I would suggest either baby powder or you can use powdered sugar. So if you take one of those powdered sugar sifters and you just sprinkle it over the wood, that'll go down onto the floor And some people like to add like some glitter to it or something like that to give it a little glitter. And you can design these any way that you want. It doesn't have to be my particular design. Use any graphics that you want. But in this design, I'm trying to make this as easy as possible, not take up too much of your time with the video. Although, you know, my videos are always long, but I try and include a few little tips and tricks and things like that throughout the video to try and help you learn LightBurn a little bit better. And I think I've done that with most of my videos anyway. At least I try, and that's what really matters. But I think this is going to be a big hit. I remember this was very popular like back in the 60s. You know, putting baby powder on a boot and stomping it and things like that. But this is such a much better idea. You know, we're now up to date where you can take this piece of wood, lay it down, sprinkle it very quickly, toss a little glitter on it, move on to the next one. And oh, actually, you're going to work your way backwards with this wood from the tree to your fireplace or from the tree to your door, whatever it may be. And this should all vacuum up really simple afterwards. You know, tell the kids, hey, Santa's been here. Don't step on his footprints. it doesn't really matter if you're using sugar. Powdered sugar, I think, is probably the best way to go. I'm going to recommend that to my kids because I'm going to make these for them. And I'm going to tell them powdered sugar sifter, and maybe a little bit of glitter. And I think this is going to be a fantastic project. I've never personally done it before. This will be the first year. I hope you like it, and I hope you try it. Also, I just wanted to let you know about the other thing that I talked about earlier, which is this four-layer Christmas card from Santa. This is another really nice project. I've gone ahead and fixed this, so it's level. I've gotten rid of the 2022. I didn't think about that when I originally made this. You know, I've changed some of these things to, you know, line after fill. I have much nicer ones that I'm actually running off on the CO2 behind me right now. That is another project that's coming up. That's going to be a cooperation. I have a big announcement to make, something new for the new year. In the next video, you'll see all about it. It is a cooperation with other makers, with two other makers at this point right now. And I think you're going to be really interested to see this next video. And I think you're going to enjoy that. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's video, learned a couple of new tips, new tricks. I hope you'll try this for your kids or your grandkids or whatever. And I hope you enjoyed the video today as much as I enjoyed making it for you. So, as always, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Next one's going to be exciting.